Very good morning, my dear students. We are studying International Trade and Business paper. In this particular paper, the first unit is International Trade. In our previous videos, we have studied different aspects of international trade, like the meaning, the distinction between domestic and international trade, importance of international trade, theories of international trade, and terms of trade. All these things in connection with first unit we have discussed in our previous videos. In this video we shall start our discussion on second unit, that is balance of payments. This particular unit, it includes following important subtitles which are shown on your screen. First one is introduction and meaning. Second one is the components of BOP. Third one is disequilibrium and causes for disequilibrium in BOP. Fourth one is remedies to correct disequilibrium in BOP. Fifth one is devaluation of rupee. Sixth one is tariffs and quota. These are six subtitles that we will be studying in unit number 2. We shall begin with introduction and meaning on balance of payment. Balance of payment is a macro concept, like tariff, quotas, forex, international trade, international business, international market. All these concepts are macro in nature. They study things in aggregate. Balance of payment is also one of the macro concepts which deals aggregate exports and imports. In this unit, wherever we use X, that stands for exports, and M stands for imports. This we should keep in our mind. Balance of payment is an index of external stability of nation, as it deals with only international transactions. Balance of payment, it does not deal domestic trade or domestic transactions. Therefore, balance of payment gives the glimpse of entire world economy. Balance of payment of a country, it reflects the economic strengths and weaknesses of a nation. It is one of the indices of economic prosperity of a nation. If we study balance of payment in detail, we can conclude many things, like whether a country is underdeveloped or developed or a developing economy. If we study balance of payment of a country in detail, we can conclude whether a country is dominated by industrial sector, agricultural sector, or service sector. If we study balance of payment of a country, we can get to know a lot of information, a lot of economic information of the nation. Therefore, it is rightly said, that balance of payment is like a mirror of a nation. It gives us lots of economic information. It is one of the indices. It is one of the economic indices of a nation. Balance of payment, it shows only international transactions. It does not highlight or speak about domestic transactions. This is the introduction on balance of payment. After knowing introduction on balance of payment, we are interested to know what is balance of payment, how balance of payment is defined. There are many popular definitions on balance of payment given by different economists in different times. For your reference, I have selected one or two important definitions on balance of payment. One amongst them is on your screen. Look at that. According to Bo Soderstrom, a Western economist, Bo Soderstrom is a Western economist who has written a very popular book on international trade. He defines balance of payment as shown on your screen. Look at that. According to Bo Soderstrom, the balance of payment is merely a way of listing receipts and payments in international transactions for a country. I have used abbreviation, that is BOP. BOP here is balance of payment. I repeat this particular definition, which is there in double quote. The BOP is merely a way of listing receipts and payments in international transactions for a country. It shows lenders or borrowers and changes in its official reserves holdings. According to Bo Soderstrom, balance of payment is nothing but a statement which shows the receipts and payments of a country which is related to international transactions. It shows who are the lenders, who are the borrowers, and what are the official changes in reserves holdings. Reserves may be cash or gold. What we learned from this particular definition? Balance of payment is a statement which shows receipts and payments of a country which are exclusively related to international transactions. This is one popular definition that I thought of sharing with you people on the screen. There is another popular economist who is known as Kindel Berger. According to him, the balance of payment is, or the balance of payment of a country is, a systematic record of all economic transactions between the residents of reporting country and the residents of foreign countries during a given period of time. What is this? According to Kindel Berger, BOP is nothing but a systematic transaction of all goods and services between one country and rest of the world during a given period of time. Now, what is this given period of time? It may be 1 year or it may be 2 years. In case of balance of payment, it is 1 year. According to Kindleberger, balance of payment is nothing but a systematic record of transaction of goods and services between one country and rest of the world during a given period of time, during one financial year. It shows the economic relations between one country and many countries of the world, between one country and rest of the world. This is what Kindleberger is trying to say about BOP through this definition. There is one important note that we should keep in our mind. When we say a country's balance of payment, we are referring here to the transaction of its citizens and the government. What is the note? Whenever we are saying a country's balance of payment, we are talking about the transactions of the citizens and the government of one country with rest of the world. This particular thing we need to keep in our mind while studying balance of payment. After studying these two important definitions on balance of payment, how it can be summarized? Look at that on your screen. Balance of payment is a statistical record of the country's economic relationship with the rest of the world. Balance of payment is a statistical record of transactions between one country and rest of the world. It is similar to that of balance of payment of a company, balance of payment of a bank. The same rules are followed while maintaining the balance of payment of a country. Receipts are recorded on credit side and payments are recorded on debit side. I think it is equivalent to that of the balance sheet of a bank or a company. So this is all about the meaning and introduction of balance of payment. After studying introduction and meaning of balance of payment, we are in a position to know some of the important features of balance of payment. These features are not different from that of the meaning of balance of payment. These features, if you study indirectly, we are speaking again the meaning of balance of payment. What are the features of a balance of payment? Number one, balance of payment is a systematic record of all economic transactions between one country and the rest of the world. Second one, balance of payment is a transaction of visible and invisible items. I need to spend a little more time on visible and invisible items. What is the balance of payment? It is a transaction of visible and invisible items. What are these visible items? We call them as goods. We call them as material goods. What are these invisible items? We call them as services. We call them as non-material goods. Meaning, balance of payment is a transaction of goods and services. Value of goods and services. Third feature is generally it is an annual statement. It is a statement of transaction of a country for a particular year, particular financial year. It is a systematic record of one financial year, one particular year. It is an annual statement. Fourth important feature is it has balance of payment has two sides, credit on export side and debit on import side. Fifth one, balance of payment is always in balance. What is meaning? Meaning is that when we study balance of payment of a country by taking the real data, at the end we find balance of payment is always balanced, meaning credits are equal to debits, meaning exports are equal to imports. Why balance of payment is always balanced? Because the double entry bookkeeping system is followed while maintaining balance of payment accounts. Balance of payment of a country always it is shown as balance at the end. Reason is we use the double entry bookkeeping system or principle while maintaining the statistical records of balance of payment. These are six important features of balance of payment that we drew on the basis of definitions of balance of payment. After studying this, we come across three situations in balance of payment. One is balance of payment is balanced. Second one is balance of payment is surplus. And third one is balance of payment is deficit. What is this balance of payment is balanced? It is balance of payment is in equilibrium. When balance of payment is in equilibrium, we find credits are equal to debits. Receipts are equal to payments. Exports are equal to imports. Now, there can be a situation like surplus in balance of payment. When we say surplus in balance of payment, we are saying our credits are greater than debits. Receipts are more than payments. Exports are more than imports. And third situation, we may also say deficit in balance of payment. When we say deficit in balance of payment, our credits are less than debits. Receipts are less than payments. Exports are less than imports. So these are three situations we come across while studying balance of payment. Balance of payment can be in equilibrium. Balance of payment can be surplus, or balance of payment can be deficit. Now, I have used two words there. One is equilibrium in BOP, second one is disequilibrium in BOP. When we say disequilibrium in BOP, we mean to say either the balance of payment is surplus or it is deficit. So this is all about the status of BOP in terms of equality of, in terms of the status of exports and imports. After studying this, In next slide, we come across BOP and BOT. What is this BOP? BOP is balance of payment, and BOT is balance of trade. These two terms look like synonymous, but they are not synonymous, they are different terms. What is balance of payment? Balance of payment is a study of value of goods and services exported and imported between one country and rest of the world during a given period of time. What about balance of trade? Balance of trade deals with value of only goods exported and imported between one country and rest of the world. Now, what's the difference? The major difference is balance of payment. It studies values of goods and also services. It studies values of visible and also invisible items. But balance of trade, it studies values of only goods, only visible items, only materials. In other words, balance of trade does not include values of services. It does not include values of invisible items. This is the major difference between balance of payment and balance of trade. From this, what we learned? We learned one thing, that balance of payment is a broader concept. And balance of trade is a narrow concept. Balance of trade is part of balance of payment. Because balance of payment, it is related to visible, invisible and capital transfer or capital transactions. Whereas balance of trade, it includes transactions of only visible items. Balance of payment is always balanced at the end, for the reason that we adopt double entry bookkeeping system. Whereas balance of trade can be favorable or can be unfavorable, can be surplus or can be deficit, even when balance of payment is balanced. Balance of trade is a part and parcel of balance of payment. So these are the things that we studied in this particular video. Friends, here we end our discussion on the meaning, introduction, the features of balance of payment. After studying this, in our next video, we'll be focusing on the different concepts of balance of payment. If you are having any queries, any doubts, any problems in understanding economics that I'm dealing with you through video lectures, you are free to call me anytime. I have given you contact numbers. I have given you my contact number. And you can call me anytime on any day to know doubts or queries in economics. With this, I conclude this video lecture. Thank you.